Hey guys, welcome to the Broken Podcast. I'm Simantoskin, and that sexy fellow over there.
Oh, stop it.
Oh, PewDiePie. You're so beautiful.
Oh, stop it. You're just trying to butter me up.
Butter your pooper.
Butter my pooper. Best expression ever. So welcome.
Oh yeah, this is the second episode. No, I guess the second episode. We got a lot of positive feedback from the first one. It made us feel all warm and fuzzy inside. Yeah. It's me.
I'm very happy about that because we talked about it in the episode or whatever that, you know, even though we'd probably still do this if people didn't really like it that much, it makes it so much more fun if people are into it. Like, I'm just saying.
That's true.
And your comments mean more than you think. So if you like something, say it. If you don't like it, shut up. Okay, no one cares.
Can they comment? I don't know what's going on with the comments.
Oh yeah, the comments. Well, first of all, in the background we have some Trials Frontier. I noticed like a lot of people didn't seem to understand what a podcast is. I guess we're their first podcast. We take their virginity, because that's all. A lot of people just be like, "What is this? It's so long." But it's like, that's the point.
I mean, why would it even be a problem that it's so long?
I don't know, but
they don't know how to use the pause button, or
I don't know. But the point of the podcast is kind of to listen to it when you have time, and maybe you're walking to work, or more likely school, or when you're doing something when you use your hands, but not necessarily your brain.
Yeah, it's kind of like background. It's kind of like listening to the radio or something.
Yeah, I think that's just described fapping thing to them. Don't fap while we're sat to
this. don't fap while walking to school.
Or that. That's probably not a good idea. But anyway, so the game in the background, Trials Frontier, you can download. It's free, so you can play along while listening. You can do something else while listening. Yeah. I think that's how you best enjoy a podcast, for me at least. So there you go. Podcast school with Puts and Ken.
Ta-da! Like, thumbs
broken
up.
A lot of people thought our name was clever. Like, so many people reached out to me and be like, yeah.
Oh, they got it?
That's a really clever name, man.
Yeah. We did it. Success.
Yeah. We thought about it so much. You gave me, like, so many shitty suggestions. Let's be honest here. I'm just kidding.
It's so like a really long email full of names that we should ever use.
Wasn't it your friend that we should probably give credit for the name?
Oh yeah, Terrence. It's one of
your
my
only
like,
black friend.
It's not my only one.
Oh okay, I'm sorry.
But anyway, I got to the point. Like, the name is the most important thing. So I was even like going and messaging on my friends back home on like Facebook. It's like, this is what it's gonna be about. What should I name it? You got any ideas? Mm. And then Terrence gave me like a ton of them, and he's like, what about How Broken or something, you know? And I was like, at first I was like, no, we don't want to name it after our YouTube stuff, you know, the like bros. The bros and stuff.
Yeah.
But it turned out to be really good, so yeah.
Huh.
That's how the name was born.
Yay. I actually said it before as a dirt silly pun, but no, ain't nobody care then. But now everyone is Terrence. Is that his name?
Yeah,
everyone's just gonna lick Terrence. I don't know what
I need to see a shrine of Terrence and like, you know, some artwork of his bound to it.
A Terrence statue is lifted. Mm-hmm. I don't know where the hell you would keep that, but yeah. So that's how it
is. I got a statue right here from PAX. This little statue right here. You can't see it, but the guys at Speedrunners.
Statues there?
The guys at Speedrunners 3D printed some trophies for us for playing their game.
Cool. Oh yeah, you won that, didn't you?
No.
Who won?
I didn't win.
Who won? Who won?
It came down to me and Nova.
So Nova beat you?
And I couldn't pull it out.
God damn it. All right. Well, you know what? I'm pretty excited because there's going to be another tournament with speedrunners, and they wanted me to invite you and Nova because they said you two won. And I will beat both your asses.
Yeah, that was like, whenever we were there and we were playing it, like Mark was there, and they're like, okay, you guys were like, you know, the top two, so do you guys want to do another one where you go get some Mark? And we're like, why? Is he like really good or something? Or
wait, you know, go and get some Mark?
Yeah, go get some like Markiplier.
Yeah, but and why?
Like, yeah, that's what we said. We're like, why? What'd he do? Well,
you're better than Mark, right? At least when we played.
Of course. I thought I was better than Nova, but apparently not.
Oh my god, I would love to play you guys in that game. That game is like, I feel like I played it a little bit more than you, so I'm like a little, like we're pretty tight. But
Oh yeah? You think you're a little better than me?
I think I'm a lot better than you, okay? I don't know how to say it. Well, up to proof, I don't know. If you're down for that, I think that would be fun, actually.
Yeah, I could do that, for sure.
Cool.
And don't let Nova trick you into thinking he's bad because he tricked Nova's everyone going, there. Nobody was cheering for him.
He became like the underdog,
so everyone wanted to cheer for him. And at the end, he's just like smoking everybody.
He's like, yeah, I've been practicing that game for months. I guess you have that underdog advantage. I guess yeah. I'm gonna practice so much. It's gonna be great. I'm gonna fucking shit on you both. That game just does weird things to me. When I play it. Yeah.
Oh, it makes you feel a little strange.
I mean, no.
Do you Hulk out when you're playing? You just get so mad?
I do Hulk out. I do. And intense. You've seen this.
Yeah, it's pretty scary.
Mm-hmm.
Turns all green.
Yeah, I become like my 12-year-old self again.
He starts like throwing tantrums. Yeah,
that annoying 12-year-old I once was. The ghost of it comes out.
I think that was a pretty good 12-year-old.
So tell me more about PAX.
PAX was packed. There were so many people at PAX. Good lord.
Oh.
That's what I remember most.
I heard it was pretty good this year. Like, it wasn't too bad.
I don't know. It's actually my first PAX, but like you walk in and you're elbow to elbow everywhere you go.
Jesus.
So
I really wanted to go there. Like, I'm really bummed out that I couldn't go, so...
It was still cool. It was just
tell me more
really
how
hard.
Bad it was. I don't care how good it was.
It was just really hard to get to any of the games you actually wanted to play.
Yeah, I hear there was a lot of lines. Like you should just be like, I'm a YouTuber. Let me through.
I got my media pass. I got to go do some things. Let me play your game real quick. But like they had the Smash Brothers game.
Yeah,
that you could play, but it was just like a big blob of people surrounding all the.
Does Nintendo care about YouTubers? Just be like YouTubers.
They've probably been like,
you staying over there. Back in the line.
I was surprised how like big it was. There's a lot of floor space, like in multiple floors. You'd like go and walk around, and you'd be like, oh my god, there's like literally like 500 booths at least, and they're all big. That's what I was amazed at.
That's cool. Well, but anyways, have you been in Seattle before?
No, it was pretty nice.
Yeah, it seems pretty cool. Like Infamous takes place there where I played, and I'm like, this thing seems pretty cool.
Yeah, in comparison to LA, it's pretty freaking nice.
I think most cities are, right?
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, let's not go into shitting on LA spree again because we're past that.
But I guess PAX, it was good. I got sick after we left. There's just not anything I really remember about this PAX.
Were you drunk the whole time?
Well, the first night they had like a Twitch party.
I knew it.
They had this Twitch party that was at a bowling alley, and they had it split up at first for like partners, like the partners of Twitch could go in first, and
there
was
really?
Like a bowling alley, so you get like you can get your lanes and everything and hang out and mingle, and then they let everybody in after that. So we had our bowling lane, and they gave us free drinks all night. And I was with Dodger and Strippin, and Strippin kept handing me drinks. And Martin was there too.
He kept handing me drinks?
Yeah, he'd just like show him and be like, here.
What kind of drinks does Strippin drink?
A lot of rum and coke, apparently.
Oh, that's my favorite drink. I want to drink with Strippin now.
Yeah. Eventually, he just started like, he'd keep giving me drinks, but they became water at one point.
What happened there?
I was like, thank you. Don't give me more of this alcohol.
I would be offended. I'm like, what are you doing? This is water. Just throw it in his face.
At that point, I had to like tell him. I was like, stop bringing me drinks, please.
Well, did he drink them?
He claims that he kept drinking, but he didn't.
Well, he's pretty tall. I've seen it actually one time.
Yeah, he's trying to be like, yeah, I can drink everybody under the table, but I know the truth.
Yeah, I'm probably the same, honestly. Okay, I can drink how much I want.
No matter how drunk I got, I still beat him at bowling, so that's all that matters to me.
I feel like I bowled better when... No, actually, didn't we bowl one time? Yeah, we did. Shit.
Yeah.
And I was pretty shit. I was. Well, that was a one-time thing, I swear. I think it's because I was not in my home country.
Yeah, there's different air or something. You know, the toilet flushes a different way.
Yeah, right. Distracted me into my bowling. Well, you guys were tryharding. Come on.
I mean, when it got to the point to where I had to close one eye so I could see single pins instead of all doubles, oh. I knew we'd gone too far.
Really?
Martin was there with us in Littlewood, and he was really good at bowling. Like,
really?
He was beating the crap out of us at first, and then we lost him. He just disappeared. I don't know what happened to him.
Well, Martin is kind of like a British. Well, he is British, and old British people seem older, and older people are better at bowling. So there you go.
That's true.
There you go. I just explained that entire thing. I don't even need to be there.
Good job.
Yeah, you're welcome. Well, that sounds fun. I miss doing stuff like that. I'm just sitting in my cave, making YouTube videos all day.
Well, honestly, if you went, do you think you would have been able to enjoy
it?
Or would you be like,
I'd probably just be too jet lagged to go out anyway. Like, that was the case last year when I went to VidCon. I told you, like, I was so pumped to, like, go to these YouTuber parties.
Yeah. Meet people.
I literally fell asleep at, like, three people. I just fell asleep at 6 p.m. and it was just depressing the time there. I was just like, God damn it. I missed the party. I checked my phone. Everyone was like, come on, the party, it's the party. We want to party with you because I'm like so popular and cool.
It's
the first time ever in my life I get to feel like that. So,
but then you were too even cool to go.
I'm too cool to go.
He's so cool, he didn't even come to the party, but you're like, no.
Yeah, that's me. Too cool to go to parties. Totally. Yep. I don't know. But it would have been fun. But
even like walking around the floor, do you think you'd have been stopped so often that you couldn't enjoy it?
I don't know about gaming events. Well, I guess there should be more people at gaming events. I'm more worried someone's gonna stab me or some shit. I don't fucking know.
Hey, are you PewDiePie? I hate your videos.
Get him! They shank me like in prison. Just one guy grabs me like, fuck you and your video.
And then the sodomy happens.
What?
I said, and then the sodomy happens.
What is that? I don't know what that
is. Oh, you don't know what that is?
Well, I think I have an idea, but tell me.
It's the butt sex.
Oh, okay. Next topic.
they're just going to throw the soap down in front of you.
Anyway. Oh, yeah. I don't know. It would be fun. I'd probably disguise myself on the floor. Unless there's a fan meeting or some shit. I don't know. Did you have that? Did you have a panel or anything?
Yeah, I was part of other panels. Like Polaris did like their Friend Zone panel, and the speedrunners thing was kind of a panel, so I got to be on that. And
that's cool.
They asked me to go to a signing with Dodger and Jesse after the Friend Zone panel. Mm-hmm. And like, I'm pretty sure maybe 25% of the people that went to that actually knew who I was.
Oh, okay. So you just had one guy that no one really knows who they are.
Yeah, and I expected that too. They were there to see Jesse and Dodger. I don't do a whole lot of things with them. So they're like, I don't know who you are. Tell me about yourself. And I'm like, okay.
Oh, like, poor
I'm Cinnamon Toast Can. No, I was cool with it. I was like, I'm Cinnamon Toast Can. And they're like, oh, yeah, I've heard of you. Sign this. And I was like, yay. I'll sign your shirt.
I was more thinking like the audience just want Jesse to talk. And then you open your mouth and I was like, God damn it.
Yeah.
You just shut up already. we want to see Dodger dance. And Jesse talk.
Dance.
I don't even know. it sounds like good times.
Whenever like was walking around with just Dodger, almost everyone that like stopped her and be like, hey, Dodger, they'd always ask where Jesse was.
Really?
Yeah.
I would more expect people to kind of be creeps around Dodger.
Oh, there was
a lot of like gaming, you know.
Yeah, Mary had a creepy guy.
Yeah, I can imagine Mary, definitely.
Jesus. They had like a little Smash Brothers tournament. Uh-huh. Like in the Polaris lounge, like all the YouTuber peoples. Mm-hmm. And she was tired. She didn't want to stay. So she went back to the hotel. The hotel was maybe 3 blocks away.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of people. So she didn't think anything about this guy.
Mary's your girlfriend. Just
Mary's my girlfriend.
Yeah.
There was a guy, you know, going the same direction she was. She didn't think anything about it. Went into the same hotel. The guy on the same elevator.
Really?
She got in the elevator and pushed the button. I think we were like on the 7th floor and he got in and pushed 8. And at this point, she's kind of getting like, this could be weird. I don't know. But she got off.
He just presses stop on the elevator and be like, you're in my domain now.
So he went up to the 8th floor and she went to like our door, which is right beside the elevator. And the elevator dings again.
Yeah.
And he like steps out before like she's gotten into the room.
Oh.
And they have that moment where they like see each other. And she like like jumps in the room and locks it and like calls the front desk and.
Yeah, that's good that she did that.
Yeah.
Don't be a creep. Why would you do that?
I don't know why. What was the thought process of that guy? Maybe if I follow this girl to her hotel door, she'll invite me in for sexy time.
I wouldn't. That's the only explanation I have. That's probably it. As depressing as it sounds. Yeah, but yeah. I don't know. Like, I was at another gaming thing, and no matter which girl it was, everyone was just like, that's a girl over there.
Oh, God.
I don't know. It was kind of. I know it's a stupid cliche, but it's there. And, yep. I don't know. It's just. Yeah. Moving on. I'm drinking a green drink. I'm wondering like how this looks like on afterwards after the green screen.
You wonder if you can like see the background or if it just looks like a big gray blob.
Yeah, I'm curious.
I got some yellow here, some lemonade. I wonder if it's got a lot of green in it.
So I'm drinking this thing that I've done once before. It's it's a juice cleanse.
Oh, you're cleansing out your body?
Too much alcohol. No. I don't know. Mud said to order it, and she asked if I wanted to do it, and I'm like, hell yeah. It was, yeah.
From what I understand, the point of these drinks are to make you poop more.
Yeah. You kind of, like, clean out your belly, kind of.
Yeah, like, you eat a whole lot of food, and you're like, oh, man, I feel fat and bloated because all this food stays in my body for, you know, 2 days or however long it stays in there. Mm-hmm. You drink this drink to flush it on out.
I'm surprised you didn't judge me more for this. I feel like a little girl.
Like Mary tries to do the same thing with me. Oh. She's like, hey, that's actually what this lemon drink is. It's got a lot of like lemon juice and other stuff in
Holy shit. Toast to that.
Yeah.
This is how real men drink. We don't drink.
I love pooping.
The thing about it, though, is that it's so expensive. It's like you won't believe how much it costs.
Don't tell me.
Well, make a guess. How make a guess?
I mean, well, what does it come in? Like a bottle or?
Yeah, you get like 6 bottles of smoothie.
$20. $20.
Up it up.
What? Up it up? 30.
Up it up.
What?
Yeah.
All right, let's go higher. Let's go to an extreme. I would think 50 would be too much.
Up it up.
What? No way.
Up it up. Come on.
80.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
$80 for 6?
$80. It's ridiculous. I don't like...
That better be like the biggest bottle in the whole world you have over there that I can't see.
It's 6 of these, I think. It's kind of stupid, to be honest. Like, we only done it twice because it's just ridiculously expensive. But it's 100% raw, organic, and unpasteurized. But
does it work?
Yeah, it works really well.
I mean, you might as well just like go spend $10 on some X-Lax or something.
I don't know. It's not something I would do often, but it's. I don't understand why it's so freaking expensive. It's ridiculous. But enough about juice cleanses.
Jeez.
It really just make you pee for a day, like 20 times.
Oh. Awesome.
I mean, who doesn't love that? So I want to also talk about the feedback that we kind of got on the comments on the video, because I left the comment on for a while or whatever.
Yeah, I didn't get to see those, but I got like a lot of tweets that were positive.
Yeah, there was a lot of, that was really cool to see. I feel like we've done some stuff that are longer before that I thought was like, this is hilarious. Like I'm sitting there just laughing my ass off for like 40 minutes and then those videos just does terribly. So
yeah,
I don't know what the difference here is. I guess there's no game to, well, there is a game. There's trust in the background, but I don't know. I honestly don't know. But
I was kind of surprised that the video itself did pretty well because like titles and thumbnails kind of matter to a lot of people. And this one was pretty, you know, broken podcast number one and the broken. There wasn't a lot of pull from that, but still a lot of people watched it. Like over 3 million. How many watched it so far?
Over 3 million, yeah. Yeah. And also, since we like talked about the comments in general and how bad they are, I feel like they put on their best behavior for us.
Oh, yeah. They're like,
which I like, though. Like, it was nice. And you could tell kind of people try to put more effort into it instead of just first. Oh, God. I just ruined all my notes.
Eighth.
and
all the way up to 301 where it stops. And everybody's like, why is this only 301 views and like 1,000 likes?
Yeah. It's,
wait, no, we can't complain. We're supposed to be praising the comments this time. Okay. Oh,
we love you.
Thanks.
I'm blow kissing. This is not looking.
So, okay, yeah, what did you see in the comments section?
Well, I don't know. People just thought it was funny and they enjoyed listening to it, I guess. I didn't see anything. Oh, sorry. No, wait. No, now I got lost in my brain. What?
I didn't see anybody say anything negative about it.
I saw. Happy. Oh, I want to get to these later, actually. I just want to talk about. No, actually, I might as well get to it now. The only bad thing I saw was how we talked about, which was surprising, actually, considering all the things we said. That they picked up on the fact that we play games that we wouldn't normally play on YouTube. A lot of people are like, oh, you're sellout. You just admitted it. Do you understand what I'm saying?
You're talking about playing games on YouTube that we wouldn't normally play?
Yeah, the fact that we play different games for YouTube than we probably would play ourselves.
Well, that's a tough thing to explain to the people that aren't part of it, though.
I think so, yeah.
I mean, because that's basically like 90% of YouTube gamers do that.
Yeah. It's probably for the vast majority of the fact. Like, do you think everyone who plays Minecraft every day don't want to kill themselves?
For real. They've been playing it for like the last 3 years or however long it's been, every day.
That was a little hard, but I don't know. Like, it's fun to do what your audience loves, and that makes it fun. You know, it's nothing sell out or bad with that, I think. Maybe, unless you're truly forcing yourself to play a game, which I don't know. I made the choice not to do that anymore because after Happy Wheels episode 70 or what I had, I literally had to force myself to do it, and I'm like, this should be a fun thing. I'm just ruining it for myself. And so
there comes to where a game isn't fun anymore.
Yeah, it really does. And I'm okay losing a couple viewers just because, so I don't have to do that. Like it's not worth it.
It's like Amnesia. You know, we all used to play Amnesia. Yeah, it was fun, but it gets to the point to where you're like, you understand the game so well that it has to be like a ridiculous jump scare to even make you jump.
That's so true, actually. Yeah, and ain't nobody play Amnesia anymore. And I still have people being like, why doesn't he play Amnesia anymore? Because I wouldn't enjoy it. And I don't see why people would enjoy it either. But I actually did play it with Kryak yesterday, I think.
Yeah?
Yeah, we did a co-op like you guys did when you made fun of me. You fucking asshole.
That was the best video ever.
So you made a video with Cry and Russ, I think?
Yeah, Russ. Well, he was trying to play, but it was on the late night with Cry and Russ.
Oh, okay. So you all played like Amnesia simultaneously and you made fun of all my references and barrels and stuff. And I watched it when I woke up and I cried so hard. I'm like, how dare they?
So there's barrels and we screamed a lot and it was just...
I don't scream? What are you talking about? When do I scream in my videos?
I don't know. You know, it's just not a thing.
I did notice like how easy it is to commentate over that game because you can interact with anything. Like it is. It is
you just like grab something and you give it a voice. You're like, I got my sunglasses here.
Like there's few games who actually have that, surprisingly, so...
Yeah, I kind of wish that Machine for Pigs had the customizable game option the original Amnesia did, but they didn't.
Did anyone play custom stories for that? Or like, I know Cry told me that they just added the assets to the original Amnesia, so you can use them there, but...
Oh, really?
Yeah, but I'd never seen a custom story from it, and it's just weird. They really killed the franchise. Good job.
Good old the Chinese room. They hate me so much.
And they are based in Brighton too. I'm kind of like hoping I will meet them just to feel the awkwardness.
You should be like, you probably wouldn't hate YouTubers if your video games had any replay value. But they don't.
So I feel like I should give them some background. So what happened was that they Frictional Games are the ones who made Amnesia, but they didn't make the Amnesia Machine for Pigs. Another developing team, Chinese Room, made it. And
these are
Chinese
also the
Room
guys
is
that made.
Yeah, they made. What is it called again? Dear Esther.
Yeah, yeah.
And you know, they're famous for being very artsy, I would say, and, you know, very, I don't know how to explain it really, but they are. And the Frictional Games sent me the game early because they understand that the reason why the original Amnesia did so well was because of me, a lot of it because of YouTubers, right?
Yep.
Yeah, I'm not wrong for saying that. No. So they sent me the game early. I did a video of it, and I upload it, and then out of the blue, the Chinese room just starts tweeting that they are really pissed off that I got to play the game early and I was doing spoilers, and I try to reach out to them, and I'm like, I understand where you're coming from. If you want to talk to me, we can work something out. And then I was about to take the video down, and then I write to Frictional Games about it, and I'm like, what's going on here? Why are they so pissed? And they're like, keep the video up. You should definitely keep the video up. We don't agree what they are saying. It's our franchise. You shouldn't listen to them, kind of.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it became a whole thing where people were just, like, saying that I make rape jokes in the video, which wasn't true either. And then that became another thing. It was just this big mess. And I got a lot of shit for it, even though it wasn't... I didn't feel like it was my fault, at least. But I should probably just have taken the video down right away. I did after a while, though. I did, like, after a couple hours.
It was just kind of a weird situation. Like, I don't even know what they were thinking. Like, yeah, they developed the game. Yeah. They don't actually own anything of it. And they're like, hey, that's our game. Take it down. And Frictional's like, what? No. Yeah. Get out of here. You guys are crazy. Your game sucks anyway.
I don't know.
I couldn't even finish that game.
The ending is actually, like, pretty good. Like, that
is the ending good?
The ending is really good. But it's just you can tell it's like a build up to the ending. So if you didn't get to the ending, you probably hated the game.
A lot. I didn't. And it's kind of like The Walking Dead. The ending makes the whole game.
Right. It is kind of like that. Yeah. Walking Dead is kind of a tedious game in a lot of ways. Like, it's very slow, and a lot of times you feel like things don't matter, but it in the end, it's like, oh, yeah, that was awesome. Yeah.
So I finally beat episode 2 or season 2, whatever they call it.
Oh, yeah.
And
can we talk about it?
Spoilers. Spoilers, everybody. We're fixed to talk about The Walking Dead if you haven't played it yet, which if you care about The Walking Dead video game, you've probably already watched it or played it. So
I feel like it.
Shut up if you're complaining.
Well, we gave them warning. So, yeah.
So I didn't like it. Like, any of the second season.
Huh. Like, not even ending. First of all, which ending do you get?
I shot Kenny in the face. I didn't even give him a chance to be sad.
Oh my god. So you looked away first?
Yeah, I like let them fight. I let him stab the girl and then I shot him.
Oh my god.
Everybody died in mine. And I was very happy that they did. I was so sick of everybody.
Did he say do it?
Yeah, he told me to do it.
You got that ending.
I was like, okay.
Wow. So that means you chose to look away first and then you shot him.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh my god.
So I hear there's like a super sad ending, right? I assume he dies anyway. I don't know.
So if you shoot him first, you get a really sad ending. That's the ending I got. Because you're like, oh.
Oh, okay.
You made the right choice.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Oh, aside from the ending, like the entire game just made me mad. Because like, how old are you? Like 12 or 10 or something in this game?
Yeah, that didn't make sense. You're right.
And like every adult you come by is like, oh, I don't know how to function. You should do everything for us.
That's so true. And I think they're aware of that. They really had to try hard to make her this beast.
Yeah. That bothered me. And then the second thing that really made me not like it was in the last episode, to where like they're trying to make Kenny look like the bad guy. Mm-hmm. You know, he's losing his mind.
Yeah, it was crazy, yeah.
And everyone's trying so hard to make him look like the bad guy that they become bad guys themselves.
Yeah, right? That's why, like, I got so pissed at the other guy, or Kelly or whatever.
Yeah, like everyone turns against you because they're like, Kenny's bad.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, but it's not that bad. I mean, geez.
Yeah, it was kind of crazy, but I don't know. Like, I was really emotionally attached to Kenny because he's been there since the beginning, pretty much. Like, he's the one character you had along with you. So seeing him go and feeling responsible for shooting him, because that was like the right thing to do. That was really emotional, I thought. And then also the other ending where you can go with him was really emotional too, actually. So
yeah.
You probably got the worst ending out of it.
I probably did. Yeah. I mean, it's like with The Last Walking Dead, the entire game was kind of iffy, but the ending really makes it.
Yeah, and it didn't make it for you.
So. You're like, this is the best game ever. But in this one, I just got like the worst ending. And I think even if I got the really sad ending and like teared up a little bit, that I still would not like it. Like, I don't even want to play the next episode because it's just like crash and burn.
Huh. Well, I see what points you're raising. But for me, it was worth it. So I'm sorry you didn't like it, but I really did.
Well, then even like when Kenny first showed up, my first thought was, okay, he's gonna die.
Yeah, you predicted the whole thing anyway, like spot on. Like so.
I think if I didn't try to do that, I'd probably enjoy it a little bit more.
That's usually the case, right?
I spoiled the entire thing for myself. I was like, okay, all these people are gonna die. And then as it went, I'm like, hey, it happened.
Yeah, but that's what we talked about too, like how. As soon as you get to have like some emotional talk with someone, that means shit's about to go down for that person.
Oh yeah, well, with Luke, he's like, "It's my birthday," and I was like, "Oh, you're done."
that's so true. I don't know. I think we talked about that last episode, but I accidentally cut it. So there you go.
Oh, okay. Anyway.
What?
Anyway.
I also wanted to. I'm surprised I haven't brought this up yet, but the fact that I took away the comments or whatever on my videos.
Yeah. And apparently that's been a big deal.
Like, why? I don't get it. Like, I saw it on some gaming sites, and I'm like, I can kind of make sense out of this. And then BBC posts about it, and after that, like, literally... I feel like every news media ever has picked up on this story that I turned off the YouTube comments. Because apparently, it's ridiculous.
You're not the first person to do it. And, like, even plenty of people have done it. But then it's like, PewDiePie did it.
PewDiePie.
We can put that name in our title and we'll get more hits.
Yeah, that's probably the case. And it's weird because it makes me seem like I'm just complaining a lot. And that's a big deal. Because for me, it's not that big of a deal, I guess. Total Biscuits has turned off comments long ago, and NerdCube has done it as well. And I did it a long time ago as well, when the comments were just insane. And it was pretty good. Like, I really felt like I had a better connection with my fans that way. So, coming back from New Orleans, okay, here's the thing. Most of these news outlets, or whatever it's called, they seem to make it seem that I did it because... I get too much hate, or I'm trying to stop people from criticizing me, or like I'm just that. But it's only because it's spam, most of it.
Yeah,
like,
it's a lot of spam.
With the top comments, people know how to exploit it, and that's what I see. I go on a video, and all I see is people writing provocative shit to get more replies, and that makes you top comment, or people self-advertising or advertising. All these things, and you know, there are great positive comments in there, but
they get covered up by the crap.
Yeah, and they are like at the bottom, and it shouldn't be like that. And I feel like it's just doing more damage than good. I know a lot of people are like, why don't you just look away? Why don't you just don't care? But it's
it also hurts your community when it's like that.
It does.
Like when people that like to comment and read the comments go down into your comment section, and all they see is all this crap. It doesn't, make them feel that great about being part of the community.
Exactly, and it does more damage than good in its current situation. So I'm just like, all right, I'll just turn them off. But it became way bigger thing than I ever thought. Like, ironically, me turning off the comments probably gave me more comments than ever. if you go to like any video that was uploaded right before I turned off the comments. Those top comments are just the worst. They're just shitting on me because I made this decision and people trolling and be like...
If you break down the numbers, your comment section really isn't even that big of a part of your YouTube channel. Like, less than 1%, probably like half of that even comment.
Yeah, exactly. I was thinking about that too, actually. It's such a tiny...
The number is so small. I mean, it matters, but the number is so minuscule that it shouldn't be that big of a deal.
Yeah.
And then there's still other options. You still got your Twitter. There's still all kinds of ways if you want to interact.
And I think that the problem with YouTube is it's just too easy to comment. And, you know, the people who support you will go through the extra mile of like going to Twitter or Reddit to support you and do that. And I get rid of all the people who don't. So I've been getting more support than ever. And I've been really loving turning up the comments. I don't regret the decision. It was pretty messy at the beginning, but it's been great.
It's just that sudden change. People hate change. Like, you turned your comments off. Make a big deal about something that's not really that big of a deal.
Yeah.
The people that are our favorites on YouTube are the silent viewers.
Right.
That silent mass that come by, you watch the video, you either like it or you don't, and you go about your business.
Yeah.
And you got that. Those are the awesome people to me. And then the people that want to comment, half of them are cool too, half of them are not.
Yeah.
And if you turn the comment section off, then it shouldn't really, like, it's not going to bother the mass.
A lot of people are like, this is the end of PewDiePie.
It's
not, I got more views than ever because of it. So, I don't know. It's been a crazy couple of days, and I literally, right before this podcast, I actually spoke to YouTube. They wanted to. They reached me out to me like late yesterday. Like, we want to talk to him, get him on a call, and I'm like, okay, next week. And they're like, tomorrow. So they're taking this very seriously. It's funny because like I've raised a lot of these concerns before. But now I guess they're taking it seriously. So
now that you've done something like taking steps, they're like, "Oh, hang on."
Yeah, I that's also kind of like, I felt like I wasn't trying to start this revolution or something or rebellion, but at the same time, it probably will go a lot faster now that I've done it.
Yeah.
So that's good. Hopefully one day the comments will be back, but for now, I'm still trying to figure it out though.
Yeah.
So it's.
I was even going to turn off my comments at one point, but then like mine aren't that bad, so I just like heavily filtered them.
Yeah, you could do that. You could definitely heavily filter. My filter is literally like a novel. It's ridiculous. I should probably like read it to you or some shit. It's ridiculous. How many words do you filter?
Oh, I'd say like 30. It's not. Not that much, but just like I got the main ones. Are you going to count yours right now?
Well, I'm kind of curious. Okay, so first, it's the first thing I filter. The word first.
Yeah, I got filtered out first too. Yeah.
I don't know why, but people in the world. I don't know why. Why is that there? I don't remember. Boobs is filtered. I don't know why either.
I think Mary got me to filter all the boobs and comments and stuff like that. Because she's like, I don't mind, but you know,
I don't mind people commenting on my tit. Anyway,
it's like, yeah, I have boobs. I'm sure they've seen boobs before. It's the internet. She doesn't like the people that make a big deal about that she has boobs when it's on the internet and like 50% of the internet is porn.
Good point.
But anyway. Good point.
Like boobs. Holy shit. Like boobs. Boobs. All like. URLs. I have like 6-10 different variations of different URLs, so you can't bypass that shit. Wanna see a problem? Because people
wanna see a problem.
Well, people kept writing "wanna see a problem" with the YouTube comments, and then they wrote this crazy thing, and that was super annoying. Gay, fag, faggot, fag lord, fag. Fag, gay,
every variation, gay,
gay lord, cunt, oh shit, I'm swearing like a mother. I didn't realize. Sorry, excuse me, pardon my French. Well, a lot of swearing. It goes on forever. I don't want to go through all it, but you get the gist of it.
Yeah. I guess the first one that I knocked out was first too, but yeah. I mean they still like go through all the numbers. They're like, oh. This is my number of comment. And like,
okay. Oh, yeah. 31st comment. Thank you for leaving that comment. It really helps everyone. Everyone.
How do you know why it's like a big deal? It's like, it shouldn't even matter, but we're still like, ugh.
Well, I think they are like proud that they are like super fan. They're like, yeah, I'm here.
The only reason I don't like it is because it like starts arguments for some reason.
Yeah, that's the
like
thing.
Like someone says first, then everybody's like, oh, who cares? I hate you. I want to kill you and all this other stuff. And you're like, whoa, calm down. let me ban that word. Jeez.
Yeah, exactly. It is like, it's not that annoying, but it just starts this conflict out of nowhere. That's why, I could go on with words, but whatever. It's not that big of a deal. It's good that we have that, though. I'm glad, like, The comments are getting better, but worse at the same time, I guess.
Oh, well.
I don't know.
Next talking point. What else we got?
I'm looking through here. I feel like we covered a lot already. What do you want to talk about? Do you have anything?
You want to talk about for comment sections? You know, if for feedback, we're going to have guests on the show.
Oh yeah.
Probably starting next week.
Mm-hmm.
And if you guys have a guest you would like to see on the show, you should totally tell us.
Cry. Make it play.
I think are we gonna ask Cry?
Yeah, I'll ask Cry. Yeah. Probably. Okay. I think, yeah, next week. We want to have guests, and I feel like we should knock out the obvious one right away. We were thinking for so long, like, we were so set that we wanted to have guests on the show when we were planning the podcast. And then we were both like, but who are we going to bring?
Yeah, no, we were so indecisive. Like, and even...
Then we were both like, okay, how about some non-YouTubers? And then we'd be like, wouldn't it be cool if this guy or girl could be on? And then we'd be like, yeah, that'd be awesome. And then it's like, but I don't really want to talk to him.
But what do we say?
Yeah, like, what are we going to talk to them about? So I think it's better if we just do what we want to do about it instead of kind of like forcing out, instead of having a guest here who just feels awkward and have no idea what we're talking
like,
about.
Yeah, like a partner.
Don't say it. Wait, what were you gonna say? Sorry,
I'll say like Maker, like the company we're partnered with, that's gonna help us out, and they're like, you know, you could probably get some actual celebrities on there.
Oh yeah,
and we're
they're
like, we have Snoop Dogg in network or whatever, and it's like, what do we even say?
Like, it would be cool to have Snoop Dogg on, but it's like, I don't know how to talk to Snoop Dogg.
It's like, what do we talk about? How's the rap game going?
Yeah,
what was up with that Snoop line thing?
Yeah.
I hear you smoke a lot of weed.
Yeah, I hear like a cloud of smoke just follow him wherever he goes. That's what I hear. But yeah.
He does it big.
I don't know. It would just be weird to have a guest over like that, and it would just make the thing a different thing. I think this thing is cool because we're just hanging out and talking about whatever. I think that's why.
I think eventually we're going to get to not having our friends on.
Yeah, fuck friends, man.
And they'll have to do like a little bit of research on the person so we can actually ask them questions that are relevant.
Uh-huh.
So do you play video games? No. Yeah.
What game? Oh. that's like me talking to anyone ever. Yeah. Especially at like the hairdresser. That's like the worst. Yeah? I'm like, they're like, what do you do? I'm like, I play video games on the internet. And they're like, oh, I don't really play games. Or if they really try hard to get a conversation, they're like, oh yeah, I used to play like
Pong. You're Pac-Man, that was awesome.
Yeah, they mentioned like this game for like 10 years ago, and I'm like, oh yeah, that game was pretty cool. I remember that game. It's like, yeah, I used to love playing that game. It's like, oh yeah, cool.
Well, this like, is cool.
It's not
this
like
is
I'm
a cool
any
conversation
better.
We can talk about. Like, yeah, when it, like, say, with, like, family, like, relatives.
Yeah.
Like, say, like, my grandparents.
Uh-huh.
Whenever I started doing YouTube and, like, I was able to quit my job.
How old are your grandparents?
I'd, like, go to, like, the Christmas thing, and they're like, so, Ken, what are you doing these days? What do you do for work?
How old are they? I want to have an idea who you're talking to.
Oh, I think my granddad is, like, 75.
Mm-hmm.
And my grandma is a few years younger than him. Like, they're the only two grandparents I have. They're still alive.
All right, keep going.
But they are like, I'm like, ah, play video games on YouTube. And they, like, just sit there and stare at me. Like, they're trying to understand what I'm saying to them. And so, like, they're like, so what is that? And every family member, even, like, aunts and uncles that are younger, I have to, like, explain the entire thing.
Oh, God,
every
it's
time.
So tedious to do
I'm
that.
Like, I'm like, it's like, how do you make money doing that? And I'm like,
Yeah, that's everyone has that too.
And then like there's the boyfriend of like a cousin or something that's there at the Christmas, and they're like, hey, how do I get into that?
Oh.
You know, I have a YouTube channel. We should do something sometime.
You should like my videos. Yeah.
And I'm like, geez.
Fuck off. No. Seriously. I hate when people do that because it's like they don't take what you do seriously or something.
And he's like, free ride, I'll take one. And you're like,
yeah, right? Not to be like that. I gladly support, but it's kind of shitty to ask, I feel like.
I don't mind. Well, like, as long as they are trying themselves to do it.
Exactly. I get what you're saying. Yeah. I don't want to mention any names, but there's been people who like literally just want me to like their videos so they can just get AdSense and they don't want to do anything. So it's like, yeah, I'm not going to do that.
It's like, I have a YouTube channel, but I haven't put any videos up yet. Do you want to play some games? You know, give me a shout out.
Yeah.
I'm like,
give me a shout out. Yeah. Yeah. That's and like, you wouldn't ask that if your profession was something else, like, say you're working for this company and you do this, kids be like, oh, can you like give me all your intel?
I don't have a degree in your field, but can you get me a job? And you're like, how do I even do that?
Yeah, it is kind of like that, isn't it? I know we're sounding very pretentious here, but it is a little bit. I don't think we're too far off.
No, it's the thing. It really is, and I hate it. It's when like friends that want to do it, because you want to help your friends out,
right?
But then you know that you're like, it's not going to be what you think it is. Yeah. You're going to give up.
Yeah, probably. I mean, it definitely helps to have someone, if you're serious about it and you want to get started, you know, I'd gladly do that.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's like you and me.
Yeah.
My channel is much smaller and we play video games together. Yeah. People come and check out my channel.
Yeah.
They don't come and subscribe to me just because I played a game with you. I mean, some may, but they'll stick around because
they might subscribe, but they don't care unless they actually care.
It'll be like
about
a dead
you.
Subscriber.
Yeah,
like,
right.
Like, I should say views instead.
Yeah.
Like, my views will go up. They'll go up and they'll go back down a little bit, but overall, they'll stay up a little bit more.
Yeah.
Because I got my own thing going. People come by and be like, oh, hey, this guy's sort of kind of funny. He's a little more serious than the last channel I just came from, but yeah, I can dig it.
The fuck are you talking about?
This guy has screamed one time in this horror video. What is this?
Is this a thing? People play horror games without screaming? Hallelujah.
This is so bad as I used to, like, before I started YouTube, like, what? I'd play a scary game and, like, people, like, when I was in college, like, my roommates would watch me play because I would scream, like, the whole time I was playing. And then I started YouTube and I, like, lost it.
Oh, really?
And I'm like, I can't even scream anymore.
You can't even scream. How dare you?
I don't know. It's like I just like jump and like freeze up. Yeah. And so I don't move a whole lot. So people are like, oh, I didn't even scare him. And like on the inside, I'm like.
Inside you had like a mini heart attack.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. For me, it's almost like a reflex now. Like if someone scares me in real life, I flinch in the same way I do in my videos, kind of.
So if I like jumped out of a closet, you'd be like,
I'd probably do like a little dance or some shit. That's usually what happens when my CEO scares me. So I don't know. It's just how it is. I guess it's kind of like how you say ow when you get hurt. It's like,
or like when you like hit something that doesn't even hurt, you say ow.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
You're like, oh, wait, that didn't even hurt. What am I doing to my life?
Yeah. I don't know. I'm so glad that I don't, like, we were talking about like playing games that you don't want to. I'm so glad that I'm not just exclusive horror or whatever. That would have been a nightmare, literally.
I always kind of worried about that. That may be one of the reasons why I like stopped screaming so much, because I didn't want to like have to keep that up if I wasn't scared.
Yeah, right.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah.
Like if I played Amnesia so much that it wasn't scary to me, which what happened.
Yeah.
And then like something super scary happened and I was just like, oh, hey. And the comment section was like, what? You've changed so much, Ken. Oh, God.
I was talking about Jacksepticeye about this, that if you don't get scared, people get kind of like pissed. It's be like, oh, yeah, he's not scared anymore. Like he used to be scared, but now he's not scared anymore. And like I play with the Oculus and it's like 10 times scarier with the Oculus, for me at least.
Yeah.
And then people are complaining that I'm too scared. So it's like you have to, according to your audience, have like a balance between not scared enough and too scared. So that's kind of like, ridiculous.
First off, we're here to watch you torture yourself for entertainment. And if you torture yourself too much, we don't like it. And if not enough, then I'm leaving.
Then there's the door. You get the door. I don't know.
It's like, thanks, YouTube comments.
Oh, my God. That's how it is. So,
okay.
No, tell me.
I was like, we got to stay away from the YouTube comments. Don't even get back on that train again.
Well, I mean, like, I feel like we covered it all pretty much, and we don't have to do it again, which we probably will anyway. But
and not everybody's gonna watch this.
Everyone's gonna watch this. What are you talking about?
Yeah, of course. How long have we been recording this?
50 minutes.
Yeah.
There you go.
You're still captivated by our voices. And maybe our faces if you're watching on YouTube.
Maybe they just muted and watched the gameplay.
What was it? Trials?
Trials Fusion. No, Frontier.
What is that on? Is that on PC or?
iPad. Or iOS.
Oh. Yeah. Is it like, do you have to like tilt it to play it?
No.
No, okay.
That would have been cool though.
We got you.
Okay.
Ubisoft, have you ever made it?
You're welcome. Free feedback. Last topic. Actually, I have two final topics.
Okay.
We have about 10 minutes left, so that's perfect. So I wanted to bring up... So there was this news about a game called Stomping Land. I don't know if you heard of that.
Oh, yeah. Go ahead.
So that's like a survival game, and survival games are like the new thing. It is...
Like the forest.
Yeah, the forest, DayZ, Unturned. Oh my god, that one with aliens. I mean, there's the list goes on pretty long, I would say. Like, it's this new phenomenon.
Fad.
There you go. I'm just going to keep saying fad. Like, anytime you go on Steam, for example, like the store for PC, it's always the top seller. Always. Mm. They're doing so well. It's like the new cash grab. And then there's this one called Stomping Land, which was a Kickstarter, where you are in this dinosaur world. And I bought that. It's in early access on Steam, which means it's not finished. So yep. I bought it, I went inside, I played for 20 minutes, I exited it, and I never touched it again, because it was just, it was fucking awful. Like, there's no substance at all in that game. It's like you can walk around in a map and not do anything. Like, yeah. It was ridiculous. And I'm like, wait, I spent, I don't know, $15 on this? I don't remember how much it was, honestly, but it was just, this is the dumbest shit ever. And now... the developer doesn't want to make the game anymore, it seems like. So the game is not even on Steam anymore.
Yeah, they haven't updated in a long time, and Steam removed it.
Yeah.
So I've heard some things. I've heard that they were recoding it in a different engine. And so that's been taking a long time.
Well, the developer hasn't said anything.
Oh, okay.
That's the problem.
That was the secondhand information that I got. Yeah. Like that they said that they were working on it, like changing the engine. But, you know... I've never seen that. It seems like they just took the money and ran.
I think that's what happened. And, you know, that's the thing with survival games. They get a lot of money. And, like, the same with Forest. Like, I don't want to be mean because it's a great series for me and I want them to keep making it. But the game is a mess. Like, it's awful, to be honest. I know it's early access and technically they're allowed. But they're making... So much fucking money for an ungodly amount of money, probably, for a game that isn't even finished, and it's insanely buggy, and anyone who probably buy the game is probably pretty disappointed, I would say.
Well, that's my problem with early access. That's, like, my big issue.
Yeah.
Is a lot of games, okay, like, you know, it's early access, it's an alpha, they're gonna have bugs and stuff. Everyone knows that, everyone accepts that.
Yeah.
But your first impression of a game matters. Like, you go in there and you play it and it's buggy.
Yeah.
And you don't like it.
Yeah.
It's an early access. You're going to put it down and there's a big chance you're never going to touch it again.
Yeah. Absolutely. So, for an early access game to be like everyday top seller on Steam, that's pretty insane. Like, that's crazy.
I mean, the Stomping Lands came out about the same time the Forest did and they were both like the top two.
Yeah.
They were like
that one. Yeah.
A while.
Yeah. It's crazy. It's kind of crazy. It seems like a thing now with just taking money for things that aren't finished or maybe not even exist. We talked about this before, but I don't want to get into details because I'm going to get in trouble. It's a shitty thing to do, really. I'm not saying in all cases it's a shitty thing to do. Like, sometimes it's awesome and great, but most of the times it's not good for the consumer, I think.
It's...
Like, you know, for every Stomping Land, there's a great game, I'm sure, but...
Yeah, there's people that do it for the right reasons, that have a good game idea, and they're willing to work on it, they just need the funds to keep going.
Yeah.
And then there's the ones that just have a game idea, that slap it on Steam, it gets approved, they take the money, and they're kind of like, I don't know what I'm doing.
Yeah. I'm sure that's the case for Forest. I don't want to. I love the game. I think for YouTube videos, it's the best thing ever because I can just kind of make fun of how crazy it is.
That brings up the bad games.
Yeah, exactly.
Not bad games, but broken games, especially make really good YouTube videos.
They make better videos, and that's just how it is. And it's more fun for me to play it too. Like if I played it by myself, I'd probably not like it. But since I'm commentating over it, I can make it funny. And you know, obviously people like it, so it's working that way.
I actually think that if The Forest was complete, 100% bug free, and was released without early access,
it would do worse.
It would have been a failure.
Yeah, you're right.
That's what I think.
I think so too. I don't think you're wrong with making that statement.
Just because the YouTube videos are so funny, and I don't care what developer wants to argue about it. YouTube videos help.
Oh hell yeah, they do. There's no argument there. Come on.
There's the ones that's like, man, they're taking money from us because of the game.
Well,
even though so many millions of people will get to see your game that may have not seen it. And
Well, I think it's because, like, just because your game is featured doesn't mean it's going to sell.
Yeah.
So some people might think, like, oh, I'm missing out on all these sales because everyone is watching it on YouTube. They think like, oh, this video has 1 million views. I should have 1 million sales now.
No, it doesn't translate like that.
Obviously, but I don't know. Some people are arrogant and stupid. That's just how it is.
Especially like, say, if you play a game, your channel sets trends. Like if you play this game, other people, especially other YouTubers, play it.
That happens.
It just trickles down. Like, I don't know. Mm-hmm. Our job is to market things. That's how we get paid. Mm-hmm. And so if we're playing your game, we are marketing your game.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know. There's an argument there, but all in all, YouTube helps. Just look at Minecraft.
Minecraft would not be big without YouTubers. There you go.
There's entire channels.
You're welcome, Notch.
May not play your game, but we know the truth.
My first video ever was actually Minecraft.
Mine too.
Oh, we should be thanking Notch.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Notch. Thank you so much. Notch, and follow me on Twitter. That's not a bitch.
You guys are Swedish bros.
I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened. But anyway, and now I use it as a reason to kind of make fun of him. So, last thing, what games are you playing?
What games am I playing? Yeah. I've been playing a lot of Flash games lately.
Oh, yeah. Call of Bieber, I straight up stole that game from you.
And Whack Your Ex.
Oh, yeah, that one too.
Even took the thumbnail with the poop on the face.
That's the only good thumbnail.
And then you kicked it sideways. It's like,
Well, special. I could fit more shit on it that way. It wasn't to make it like, oh, yeah.
Wait, what was the third game on that video?
Breakfast Simulator. You play Flappy Bird and eat cereal at the same time. It's brilliant.
That sounds pretty hard. Have you played Swing Copters?
Yeah, I played it before you, but you uploaded it before me.
Ha!
So there you go.
That game's hard.
That game is really hard. It took me forever to realize that I have to tap to change direction, because I tapped so fast that I didn't notice that it was doing that.
You were just like, boop, 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 yeah. I got one. Like, that was my top score, was one.
Really?
That's all I could get.
Oh, I got seven. I got seven.
I mean, I just sat there for like a video, so I played it for 10 minutes.
I played it for probably 20.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, 20 minutes for 7. That game was a little too hard.
Yeah, I didn't really enjoy it as much as Flappy Bird. Flappy Bird is pretty smooth, because it's just like flapping a flappy, if you know what I mean.
And it didn't have like the swing hammers. They add a lot to difficulty.
Fuck those swing hammers.
But the Flappy Bird is definitely more fun, even though I hate that game still. The Swing Copters.
How you been playing, Pidge? Oh, me?
I thought this was all about me. My bad. Yeah. Flash games. Douchebag Beach. Another douchebag games. Yeah. What have you been playing, Mr. Felix?
I don't have a good answer, to be honest. Like, I don't.
Yeah.
Oh man, it was so funny. I was sitting a meeting with Xbox the other day, and they asked me that question, and I'm like, holy shit, I have to say an Xbox title.
Did they ask you what Xbox games you're playing?
No,
or
they just said games, but I wanted to be polite. So I want, like, quick, give me an Xbox title.
You should have said Dark Souls. Dark Souls 2.
I know, and first that came to mind, it was Dark Souls, but I'm like, for some reason I thought it was PS3 exclusive, because the first one was the Demon's Soul. So I'm like, fuck, come on, come on, come on, come on. Dead Rising!
They're like, wow, that old game?
Oh, man. It was pretty awkward.
Is it Dead Rising 3 that came out recently?
On PC, yeah, too. Yep.
I hear it's really
Yeah, it was bad. A bad port. I hate when that happens. Stop doing that. God.
I mean, how do you even have a bad port? They're playing their own computers to make the port, right?
It's like they don't change the buttons or the key bindings. They don't add any of these like changes where you can change the resolution or anything. But it's like, how hard is that to do?
They're like simple options. And then the frame rate's supposed to be really bad too.
Yeah, I guess they're optimized for a different bend. I don't understand how it works. I mean,
if you're going to make a port, you got to give it different resolutions. You got to give it windowed mode.
Field of view.
I mean, field of view is kind of like here and there depending on what game you're playing. Like if it's Dark Souls, they had field of view on that? I don't think so.
No, you're right.
Like something like that, mm-hmm. but like a first-person shooter, you need field of view because some people get sick with the small field of view.
Oh,
but
yeah.
Anyway, there's just
yeah,
like simple things, like really easy things to do. That's just like interface things.
I wonder how many developers in-game. Listening to this be like, oh, yeah, that's good. All right. get it right. It's like no one gives a shit. This is not going to.
But still, I mean, that's what Total Biscuit claims that got his channel popular is complain about options.
And the field of view. Well, he does it like every beginning's bad. All right, let's go into the options and see what they have. Like, to me, that doesn't seem like the first thing you care about when there's a review, but. I guess we all have different priorities.
Yeah.
And on that note, that was the Broken Podcast.
Woo! Yeah!
We did it.
We did it.
I think that was an hour. Yeah, that was an hour.
Yeah, we gotta have a, like maybe a sign-off or like a save or something.
First of all, check out Trials Fusion if you enjoy the gameplay and you can, if you want to listen to this again, you can just download it for free and enjoy it and all that good times.
Yeah, it's on SoundCloud and iTunes soon.
Soon, because you had one jab, Ken.
Okay, I'll talk about that later.
Next time. We'll probably have a guest next time, too, but we'll probably split it up anyway. But anyway.
Yeah.
Sign off.
Stay toasty, broskies. What was yours? If it's not broken...
Don't flix it.
Don't flix it.
A frame broken, don't flix it.
Hey. Stay toasty, broskies.
Stay toasty, broskies. I almost did a bro fist, but I realized that's not it. Okay.